Hi, in this video we're going to be talking about who's talking about what Ivica is talking about the sensor plate in his videos. But now, would you look at this sensor plate? And here, look at it closer. If you see the airflow meter and the sensor plate here, do you see maybe, let me just show you, look at it. Look how deep it went down. Why? What do you think? Why? This is the reason why it went so deep in. With such a play in the sensor plate, you won't be able to start your car. You will have misfires, you will have vacuum leaks, of course. Look, this is unacceptable. And now, someone wanted obvious to lower this sensor plate, and he did it here. If you remember, I've been talking in my videos, in that video about the Ke-Jetronic diagnosis, about how to repair that video, I'm going to post it here. And there I said that the more you hammer this part here, the more you're going to lower the sensor plate. And this is done only if you have experienced detonations. And that's why, and then the sensor plate would go up the more than it should. Here, this is what you're going to get. Look at this now. Let me show you somehow here. The sensor plate should come right up to here or here. Here, approximately. I can, let me show you with my index finger. Here, if you see where my nail is. So that's how much above it should go. If you experience any detonations, it will go up. The more it goes up or down, you'll get vacuum leaks. So it's not good, then you won't have good idle. How do we do this? How do we make this right again? Well, it's not as easy as it looks like, but let's do this. Okay, before I go to the table there, I'm going to tell you just that you will need to unscrew all these bolts here. As you see them, you will have to take this breather hose off, you will have to take this rubber boot off. It's really, really a pain in the chest in order to do this job. Okay, but let's do it, shall we? Well, in order to do this job, you will need a tool like this. and a hammer. And now you will have to put it here. And just to hammer. Here. The more you do this, the more the plate is going to sink. Here, this is what you get if you hammer too much this wedge or nail, however you say it. Okay. Look, let's say here is the fuel distributor. And now, look close at this. This is the line where the sensor plate should rest. And look how deeper it is. Look how deeper it is in comparison to its original start position, as it should be. This is what happens if you hammer it here. And one more thing. When you're done with... sorry. When you're done with all this, and when you get the plate here, where it has to be, when you get it back, then you will have to purge the air out of the system, out of these four. You should be aware of that also. If you just, when you're done, put it back, you screw all the screws back, and you start the car. It won't run as it should. Okay, let me show you here. At first, okay, I have two screws only, but look what you're going to do. So here, be extra careful with this. This can happen usually if you have detonations because of the lean mixture and something like that. So you will have to take this off. And let me simulate the real conditions. And here's your fuel distributor. So it's in your way. Well, it's up to you. Whether you're going to take this part off or not. Well, and what do you think? Why did I take this off? Because to make this straight and to get it back, you will have to flip this part over. And then you will have to hammer it here. Here. You will have to hammer it back. So let's see how this looks like. Okay. At first, let's do it with a hammer. Let's see. Just a bit. You must be very patient and you must be very careful. Because you can also damage this part. This is not recommendable to do. You must be extra careful. Here. I've made it. But let me show you what happens here, the more you do this. Here, look. Look at the sensor plate now.
Aww.
Look what's happening. So once again, the more you tap or you hammer this part with a hammer from underneath, like this, here, this is what you're going to get. Look at this now. And now you must do the reverse thing here. Let's do that here. Oh my god. Now I damaged this.
No!
So, as you have seen, it's not as easy as that. And just be careful, because it's not recommendable, again, I must tell you, to hammer this part here. And one more thing. After that hitting with a hammer, I had to take off the potentiometer to check if I didn't break these contacts, these two. Luckily they survived. That's a good thing, because if you damage those, if you break them, you can say goodbye to the whole this unit. I've been talking about that. You will have to look for the same one, and you will have to search it here by the plate. If you see these numbers, it says 0438121001LM0001. So this one was on a car, on some car. And if you have one like this, or whichever you have, then you will have, if you did damage those two, you will have to buy this whole unit. Well, that's how it is. Because nowhere on the market you can find these two to buy them. No way. So, my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.